Hey guys, welcome back to Top 1% and welcome back to the last video of 2019 on my channel. And before we start this video, I'd like to thank all of you that has shown me support throughout this year. I know this is a new channel and it's been about 4 to 5 months since I started making videos, and there's a lot I need to learn and a lot of work for me to do before this channel grows. But there has been a lot of you that's consistently followed my content and shown me support, and I genuinely want to thank you from the bottom of my heart. It's your support that keeps me going. And let's get to today's video. I'm going to talk about New Year's resolutions and if they're worth it or are they all just hype, just empty words. So let's get started with today's video.
I am in the top 1%.
So when it comes to making New Year's resolutions, there's one category of people that just want to do it for the heck of it, right? They just want to find a way to find some resolutions and just go on with it. And when the year started, they're all hyped up. They have all the intention in the world to follow through and make their goals a reality. But then when it comes to getting the work done, they don't do it. It's like soda bottle pressure. They just fizzle out and they don't get the work done, simple. And then there's a second category of people that set their goals straight and have a vision, have a clear goal, clear direction of what they want to do, what they want to achieve, and then make their actions match their words. And that's what I'm talking about in today's video. When it comes to being successful in anything, any successful person, they don't just roll out of the bed and decide to go with the flow, right? Before they go to bed, they plan what they need to do for the next day, that is short-term goals, and New Year's resolutions. These are long-term goals. I think it's a great way to end your year, looking back at how the year went and what you achieved, what you could not achieve, where you failed, and what you could learn from them, and setting solid goals for the next year so that you have something to work towards. When you achieve something, you reach a new high, you are successful in something, that gives you a new level of confidence. And when you fail at something that you planned on doing, that humbles you. That makes you more wise and makes you realize where you stand and where you need to be. And that I think is really important. We all have ups and downs in our lives. We all have highs and lows, and that's really what makes us human, right? We can't have this constant success throughout the year. That's not possible. And this process of ups and downs, that's what makes us better. That's what makes us more close towards being in the top 1%. And this is what I do. I've been doing this for the past 3 years. I write down my goals on a piece of paper. It's really simple. It's about 10 little goals that I want to achieve throughout the year. I won't bore you with the details of what I have written here, but it keeps me in check. As of 2019, I achieved about 70% of what I planned. The remaining 30%, it gave me a reality check. It made me realize I need to work harder. And yeah, 2020, new goals, new resolutions. Let's get this year started with a bang. So make your actions match your words. That's all I had to say about New Year's resolution. When you go to the gym, you see a new set of people that are there that are all hyped up and want to work out. But within 1 month, all of them are out of here. The gym attendance, it just drops down to really low. And if you need some help with your New Year's resolutions, you need some help with setting goals, then here's something that might help. I recently heard a quote which I really liked. And here's how it goes. Each person needs 3 different hobbies. One hobby to keep you healthy, one hobby to make you money, and one hobby to keep you creative. And coming to the 3 hobbies, just to give you an example, one hobby to keep you healthy, fitness, that's the core of everything I do. Apart from that, I also like martial arts, and that's something you can try your hand at. It's really a lot of fun, and it's gonna make you a better person. And coming to the hobby to make you money, that's your profession. What do you do to earn money? And the third hobby, which is to keep you creative, this is what I do. I make YouTube videos. I like drawing. Apart from that, I like playing keyboard. Although I didn't do much of playing keyboard this year, that's something I need to work on. Anyways, so these are the 3 hobbies, 3 types of hobbies that you need to work on. And that's something you can work into your resolution. And I hope that helps. So that's all I had to say about New Year's resolution, guys. Make each and every single day count. Make each and every year count, right? If your 2020 is not gonna be better than 2019, you're the only person that's responsible for it. It's up to you to make sure that your 2020 is better than what 2019 was. And that's what I try to promote on Top 1%. Being in the Top 1% means improving every single aspect of your life. Your physical health, your mental health, your social life, your confidence, your personal life, your professional life, every single thing. You want to be in the Top 1%, you're gonna have to work for it. So if you enjoyed this video, hit the thumbs up, share this video for all those people who are planning on having New Year's resolutions and make them actually follow through it. And thanks for all the support throughout this year. And until next year, take care, stay hungry.